Hey guys, Vinnie here with Say It Once Dog Training. Springtime's here, and with spring comes a lot of thunderstorms, and this is a really, really difficult time and stressful time for a lot of dogs and a lot of dog owners as well. I'm going to walk you through step by step so how we can desensitize our dog and make them confident around loud noises like thunderstorms and fireworks. There's a few different steps you're going to want to take to build your dog's confidence around loud noises. The first step is to actually get your dog out and about doing something they enjoy around different loud noises. It's not all dependent upon the thunderstorm. And that's what most people think is, oh, I have to train when it's just thunderstorm. No way, man. So when I rescued him, he was petrified. So we went to different bus stations. We went to different moving truck stations. And with all the compression from the bus or the air coming off the bus and the noises from the trucks coming in and out, it was hard for him at the beginning. Now, when we started this, we started 100 feet away, and we did something that he liked more than his fear of that bus or that loud truck or whatever it is. We also went to two different gun ranges, started far away, working closer, so he can build confidence around these noises. What you want to do is put your dog on the outside of the threshold. So say my dog's comfortable 200 yards away, but he's very uncomfortable 175 yards. That tells me I have to stay 200 yards away. I have to find something he likes. Now, what is Thurman like? He likes trick training and he likes anything that he is going to get a treat for. Right? He's a super high motivated dog, so it's a little bit easier when they're hungry. I would also suggest when you're trying to overcome fear, use hunger to your advantage. What I don't want you to do is feed your dog and then go to try to train him. That's not going to work. That's not going to cut the mustard. Keep your dog hungry by not feeding him breakfast. Then let's use food, whether it's his food or treats, high value treats, out during our training session. I want to slowly get closer to the loud noises, whether it's gunshots, whether it's buses, whether it's trucks, whether it's whatever. Their body language is extremely important during these sessions. If they're shutting down and the tail is tucked completely underneath, you've pushed your dog too hard, abort the mission and retry another time. But if your dog's tail is down and he's slightly stressed, however, he's continuing or she's continuing to do the exercises, that's okay. This is not supposed to be not stressful at all. The dog has to go through relatively a good bit of stress in order to feel confident around this. You just have to know when to push the gas pedal and have to know when to back up on your dog. Their body language tells you though, right? So if they're hunkered down and I can't move, well, clearly I screwed up and I misjudged how far I can push my dog. Another great way to desensitize your dog is through your phone. You can play thunder, you can play fireworks, you can play gunshots, alarm noises on your phone, and almost everybody has a portable speaker that makes this a little bit louder and a little bit more significant. You can go to an empty parking lot, put the speaker underneath your car and train 20 feet from your car as it's making these weird noises. Once again, always checking in with our dog, always seeing how is their body language, how is their behavior. Everything I just mentioned is to boost our dog's confidence around loud noises for the future. You have to start doing these now in order to fix this a month down the road. But what about the day of? What are some things I need to be aware of the day of a thunderstorm? First off is your energy. If you're a nervous wreck, how the hell do you expect your dog to follow you confident and calmly? It's not gonna happen. Now that doesn't mean if you're calm, your dog's gonna be calm, but the situation will be significantly better if you stay calm. You better exercise your dog the day of a thunderstorm. If you don't do anything with him all day long and he's already pent up and he's already anxious, well, you know what's going to happen. He's going to be 10 times worse pacing and whining throughout the house. It's easier for a dog to be calm when they're exhausted. Do a really good play session, a really good leash walk, and some obedience training. So now we have two options when the thunderstorm happens. If my dog is shutting down no matter what, put the dog in the quietest part of the house, typically the basement. Play louder music or louder TV upstairs. Go downstairs and watch your TV and just keep calm. What I don't want you to do is please don't say, it's okay, baby. It's going to be all right. You're going to reinforce your dog for being afraid and fearful of that loud noise. If your dog is currently at that position, we have a lot of work to do. Refer back to the beginning of the video and get our dog confident around loud noises. Now let's talk about the dog who is stressed out, but still able to do training. This is the position that we need to be in, and this is where you get success. Now, you're going to go into the part of your house, which is the most quiet, typically the basement again, and we're going to start training exercises during the thunderstorm. So while the thunderstorm's going on, and normally you want to start this not when your house is shaking, but when you can just start to hear the thunder go on. Once the house starts shaking, it might be a little too late. So we do things that are known behaviors. We're not trying to teach anything new. I'm not trying to teach my dog to put the toys in a basket. I'm going through the stuff he knows. Sit, down, stay, come, back up, spin around, roll over, whatever the hell he knows, use those to your advantage. The dog, whatever his favorite activity is. Now, for some dogs, it might not be just training. It might be some fetch and some toy drive. Cool, get out the toys. Use your highest value item. Now, the trick here, once again, is to move closer to the noise as my dog gets more confident. So if I can do it in the basement with a little music going on outside and the thunder's still coming closer to the house, then I get rid of the music and I go into the basement. Then I can go upstairs, turn the music on slightly. Now I'm closer to the thunderstorm until eventually I can come into a room like my garage and where it's gonna be a little bit louder, or my sunroom in my house, or whatever it is in your house, your enclosed porch. And now we can start doing training with some music on, then turning the music off, and then eventually it doesn't matter. Now, once we get to this point, that doesn't mean you stop desensitizing your dog towards the thunder. You're going to continue to do this for a long time. Your dog has had this fear, not for a week. It's been something your dog's been living with, so don't expect, oh, I got to this point, now we're done. No, now we're in management phase. We continue to do this every time there's a thunderstorm or fireworks. You should still be practicing going around loud noises too. As we progress through these steps, then it's time to start doing training outside when the thunderstorm's approaching or going away from the house. Right now, the thunderstorm's a mile or two away. You could hear it rumbling in the background, but it's not shaking my house. It's not raining. There's no chance I'm going to get struck by lightning right now, knock on wood. Now I want to go outside, and I want to do my training out there, whether it's leash walking, playing ball, getting him around. Now, this is very important. Getting them around other dogs who don't care about thunderstorms is awesome. The mirror effect. My dog can see that that dog's not petrified at all, and that dog wants to play, makes life a hell of a lot easier. Use those dogs to your advantage. You can even bring those dogs over for a play date in the basement of your house. It's a great option too. Remember, don't rush your dog throughout any of these steps, but you have to be willing to take the bull by the horns and start doing something to fix the actual problem. Too many people try to put a band-aid on it the day of, and that's not good enough. We need to be a better dog owner and fix this fear. I don't want my dog living like this forever, so let me start to get them around these noises more frequently. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. You might notice I have my Best of the Berg shirt hoodie on. I have the best clients in the world. One of my clients got me the Best of the Berg hoodie. If you could do me a favor, if you enjoyed this video, share the video. And two, give us a vote on Pittsburgh's Best. I'll post the link below. Thank you guys so much, and have a great day. Hey guys, so right now we've got a little thunderstorm all around us. It's kind of shaking the house a little bit. And remember, when I rescued Thurman, he was tied to a stop sign, and supposedly there was buses. The story really doesn't matter. All that matters was he was petrified of buses, trucks, thunderstorms, lightning, gunshots, the whole nine yards. So when we got to a point where, as he got more confident and as the closer I can get to the thunderstorm, more eventually it would go off like it is now and he doesn't care, I would do more and more training as close to the thunderstorm as I possibly could. So we're in my sunroom where there's, you know, it's really loud in here when it starts to shake the house. And this is a good exercise. Now remember, he's been over this for 5 years. We still do this. You never stop training. And the training exercise you do during the thunderstorm doesn't matter. So it doesn't mean like, oh, what exercise do I have to do? Whatever your dog likes most. Thurman just happens to like a few of these ones most. Yes, good boy. Just for him looking at me is a beautiful thing. Good. Keep. Good. So I'm going to take a treat right here. I'm going to hide it. Oh, you guys can't see that. So we'll hide it here. Fight! Obviously he knows it's in the general area. Thurman, you're not doing a great job of being a coonhound right now. Then to his defense, this is kibble, so it doesn't smell. That's a good boy, but he should do better than that. Keep through. Hey, kibble. Line. You can hear, I'm assuming we could hear it on the cameras. That's nice. Let's chew our food, bud. Let's chew our food. That's a good boy. Really ruining the shot. That's still. Find it. Good eyesight too from a coonhound, which is a beautiful thing. But remember, it's all about watching his body language. If he would get super stressed and his tail would get tucked underneath, I wouldn't do the training out here. Now, that being said, if his tail was like a little unsure, but he was still willing to do the training, I would continue with the exercise. I wouldn't stop it. It's just when they get to a point where they shut down, you never want to put him in that position. So him going through a little bit of a stress, that's fine. That's not a problem at all. Him super excited, well then clearly you don't have any issues, so it's not that big of a deal. Him not being able to chew food, then we got a problem. That's a boy. That's... But...